class, this is another example of finding or creating a bar graph and a pie chart for qualitative data. We're still using the class survey data with previous class data Excel file that we used for ethnicity in the previous example. We're now looking at gender. This is the one we did in class. That was question 6, and the responses were either female or male. And as you look down the list, there's no organization here at all. So the first thing we would need to do is click on A so that we select the entire column. And then on our home menu, go to sort and filter, and let's sort A to Z. So what happens is all of the female responses are first and the male responses are at the bottom. Now you could create a table, gender and frequency. So this is another frequency distribution. Let me reset the size of column E. Doesn't want to do it, so I'll manually move it over. For the genders, the two genders were female and male. If we count these, female, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 females. And then I'm going to have to scroll down so I can see the entire end of the row, or column, excuse me. Male, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So there are 18 males. So we've created a frequency distribution. Let me fix the spelling on frequency. And this is an option for qualitative data. So if we want the options for graphical displays for qualitative data are, of course, the frequency distribution table or chart, but we also have graphs such as a bar graph or a pie chart. So I'm going to select the table. I'm going to click on gender and shade. I'm going to try that again. Click on gender and shade. There we have, I've shaded or selected the table of values, the frequency distribution. I go to the menu and select insert or click on insert, and there is a column chart, which we refer to as a bar graph. And so here you see your chart, and the name of the chart, frequency isn't a good name for our chart, but we can call this gender . So the gender of our from our class survey shows the number of females and males. Now if we click on our chart, I can add some chart elements like data labels. And if I go to more options, we can change where we have the numbers. But for gender, there are 9 females and 18 males from the chart. We can add an axis title. And the vertical is really the one I need to add, the axis title there. This is where we could do the word frequency. So you have a nice table with from your frequency distribution table, then we have a bar graph. Now you might also want to insert, let's select this again and insert a pie chart. And so I'm just going to pull the pie chart down over here a little to the left And I'll move the bar graph a little over to the right so we can see both of these. And so when I click on this chart, we might want to do some data labels. And I can have more options. Let me try that again. Data labels. More options. There we go. And I'm going to include the category name and the percentage. So this way you could see the relative frequencies for the two categories. We could add that to part of our table. So the relative frequency. Let me fix the width of our column there so we can, there we go. So the relative frequency for females is 33% and for the males is 67%. We can change the relative frequencies from percents to decimals. If we'd rather, we can say that that's 33% or 0.33 as a decimal. The 67% would be 0.67 as a decimal. So you can have relative frequencies this way. And what we've done is we have used a process where we first sort the data and then count the number of times each category appears as a response from the column of values. In the next video, we will use the pivot table, inserting a pivot table and chart to make the process a little easier.